¡Ay! ¡Ay, qué fiebre! ¡Ay!
Welcome back. I hope you enjoy my podcast. If you didn't enjoy them, you wouldn't be back. Well, today I want to read a chapter from a book of mine I've written. It's part of the Nemesis Horizon Project series. And this book is called David Lazarian. I'm going to read a chapter and hope you like it. First chapter is called David Lazarian. I know I'm a fucking slut. I love getting fucked up the ass and choking on your big brown cock, I said to the elderly looking grayish tan man. We met under the boat slip resort hotel in Promisetown at the 2006 Bear Weekend event. I was a young age of 20, and Raymond was a hot older man in his 50s. He had the physique of a 30-year-old, but his face told another story. It had the look of the wear and tear of that of a 70-year-old. Now that I was 10 years older, our sexual bliss was waiting fast between us. I got the feeling that Raymond found a new young boy toy. No more were the slobbering wet kisses. No more were the waking up in the middle of the night sweating from his working my body incessantly with his cock. No more of his slithering, biting tongue licking his way down my perineum after it released my balls from its circumvallation. Then it worked its way deep into my anal canal, making my whole body tremble and shake uncontrollably. The writing was on the wall. This was our last Bear Weekend vacation on Cape Cod. Raymond and I were standing at the bar, drinking as usual. At the corner of my eyes, I noticed a cute older gentleman standing all alone behind us. I sensed a reptilian hybrid vibration like Raymond. After 10 years of living with one and always surrounded by them, it heightened my perceptions of them. This hybrid was different. This hybrid was more human. He also had a great body, but his face was older in appearance, but babyish, making him look younger than his age. This dark, handsome stranger had me hooked. I knew he had to be a hybrid. Ever since being with Raymond, I craved their diverted touch of passion. Their whole body became extremely hot. It felt so heavenly when a hot, hairy hybrid pounding in my ass, making me scream for more. I was hooked, so I quickly turned and faced the demon. Hello, my name is David. This is my partner, Raymond, I said, announcing my sexual intent using my eyes. Glad to meet you, David, he replied as we shook hands. Come on, babe, that's our song they're playing, Raymond said as he pulled me away from the stranger. After the dance, I returned directly to the stranger. You didn't tell me your name, I said. Stefan. My name is Stefan, David. No need to go into details about the huge argument Raymond and I had that night. He's a fucking hack hybrid. He doesn't give a fuck about you, David, Raymond yelled at me as his white pupils turned blood red with anger. What do you care? I yelled back. You got your boy toy, and I got mine. That was that, and I never looked back. I left Raymond with an empty refrigerator, unpaid electric and cable bill, not to mention 2 months' rent. I was free from supporting him and his huge cock. Stefan was quite an extraordinary hybrid. I laughed when he told me on our first date of his being a reptilian hybrid. I don't want to freak you out, he started. I am what they call a hybrid, half human and half reptilian. I don't care what you are, just as long as you fuck me long and hard with that big bulge pushing its way through your pants, I said. I think I shocked him with my honesty. I knew from the size of his bulge he was not small at all, and besides, I'm a fool for brown cock. I was a size queen and proud of it. I loved getting fucked by at least 9 inches. Raymond had 10 and a half, and so far the biggest dick that had the pleasure of my hairy hole. Stefan was different. When I stared into his eyes, I saw these bright, shining eyes beaming into my brains. I told him how Raymond and I met and how he broke it to me about being a hybrid. It was his kisses that gave it all away, I laugh. I also warned Stefan that I was not into older men. I loved my boys young, hard, and hung, but once I saw Stefan naked, I knew he was the man for me. Even at his age, his muscular body would put a lot of young men to shame. His muscles were natural, not made in the gym. His muscles weren't like Raymond's muscles at all. Raymond's muscles had a worn-out, leathery feel to them. His muscles looked good for the eye candy, but they didn't have that hard, new muscular feeling like a 20-year-old. Stefan's muscles looked and felt like brand new. He was hairy, but not over hairy, like I've seen when traveling around with Raymond in the hybrid world. Stefan's eyes opened wide when I told him that there is a whole worldwide community of hybrids out there. I told him how Raymond introduced me to a Mr. Fernandez, who was famous for gene and DNA manipulation. He's been accused of cloning humans. The United Nations outlawed him, so he's hiding in the Philippines now, I laugh. Will you marry me and have kids together? He asks. I'm not a hermaphrodite. I'm 100% human male. I'm a 100% human male. I can't bear children, I explained to him. I know, but this doctor can put our DNA together and hypothetically bear our children in a test tube. What an awesome fucking idea, I screech. Yes, I'll marry you. I kissed him deeply, like I used to kiss Raymond, and then Stefan sealed it by sticking his tongue deep down my throat, latching onto my tonsils, making my nipples rock hard. We got married on the beach in Provincetown. I was so excited. I had an erection the whole time. Stefan had one too, and our friends loved it. We walked down the aisle with protruding bulges wearing our tuxedos. Stefan wore white and I wore blue. My bulge was big, but Stefan's bulge was huge, and I felt like a movie star marrying a man that everyone in Cape Cod wanted to jump his bone. We honeymooned in Ka Pai Nang. Dr. Fernandez met us there with his crew. That was when we gave him our sperm and blood to start the cloning process. I used the term cloning because according to the doctor, our children were going to be replicas of us. He joked about it, but it also stated that since they were going to be our replicas, they were like stored body parts for us to use if any of our organs fail or got old or too old to function properly. This information gave me an orgasm. I couldn't wait to see our offspring. After the first month of marriage, I found out that I hit the lottery. My hybrid husband was rich and famous in the reptilian world. He told me his story and never had to ask for anything. He graduated from UCLA with a BS in engineering. He had unknown connections to NATO sources. His grandfather, leader of the reptilians, gave him everything he ever wanted, including you, he said to me in one of our heated sex sessions. We move onto a 10-acre ranch in the western part of Virginia. No neighbors for miles around. I had my first visit with my grandfather-in-law. It was all done via hologram. He was a character. He looked very human, with the exception of his eyes. His eyes were definitely not human. He had a sense of humor in a weird reptilian way. He demanded respect and would kill to get it. He was a ruthless and a force to be reckoned with. David, welcome to the family, he said it in a formal manner, but the inflections in his voice vibrated a zero tolerance for any of my foolishness. My new boy toy had an overbearing protector. I was a kept woman, and I loved it. Since I never graduated high school, I never needed to struggle. The jobs I've had were pretty decent. Now, there were no need to work except for keeping the ranch manicured and immaculate. We were self-sufficient. We didn't need the outside world or the humans for anything. Humans are poison to the reptilians. Their way of living, thinking, and surviving on this planet is contradictory to our way of life, according to Granddad. Stefan had to remind me. The day arrived for us to pick up our kids. You two are now proud fathers of male triplets. Unfortunately, they were quadruplets, but one was stillborn. Dr. Fernandez explained as he looked at us over the frame of his eyeglasses. Their birth certificates are as follows. Trey Reptilian, Tyrone Reptilian, and Tyler Reptilian. I have a tag, each one with their names. Each of their certificates have their fingerprints on them. Do not worry. I am sending a nurse with you to care for the boys until they are 3 years old. After that, you will be on your own. He smiled as he stood up and a nurse entered the room at the same time. Kim Lay will take you to the boys, he said. As we followed her out of the office, he grabbed me by the hand, pulling me extremely close to him, and whispered in my ear, "Try to get away from Stefan and meet me back here." I did as the doctor ordered and returned to his office. He handed me a bottle of pills. "Here, you're going to need these." "What are they?" I asked. "They are your sanctuary from constant surveillance," he laughed. "What are you talking about, Doc?" "Your mind is going to be bombarded with voices and visions. You are going to be living in a household with four reptilians who will have the ability to read your every thought. These pills will block them from your mind." The doctor turned out to be a lifesaver with those pills. I asked him to clarify the clone aspect of the boys. "Clone?" he said in a questioning tone. "I won't know about the cloning aspect until they get a little older. Their DNA and genes may morph more into reptilian cells instead of human cells. Time will tell, but I would make you a proposition. It has come to our attention that your husband has not evolved into his potential. He is still growing up, so to speak, to be either a full reptilian or something we have never seen before. We need to keep an eye on him," he said as he got up close to me, face to face, and he looked dead into my eyes. "Do as I ask, and I promise to replace any failing organs in your body from the child that replicated your DNA and genes. I can make you live for 200 years. He propositioned me with a grin. "I accept," I said, returning the grin. His thoughts on the reptilian hybrid boys coincide with mine. They were organ farms to be harvested. And that's the end of chapter 1. And my book right now is being sold on my website for 99 cents. That website is frutaextrañaproduction.com. So, if you like it, fine. If not, maybe next time. Anyway, this is Eric, and what you just heard was the craziness that lives inside my head.
Suave. No, no, no.